Welcome to GYAS. How are you? I hope you are doing well. So friends, as you know that on our channel, we are covering the syllabus of UPSC Civil Services, and for that purpose, we have started multiple series on our channel that target your prelims as well as mains. So currently, we have 12 series that focus on your prelims and one series that target your mains. So what we do in these prelims-oriented topic series, we have basically divided your whole syllabus into 12 large subtopics, and we daily pick up two subtopics for discussion. And in this manner, in 6 days, we cover all your 12 subtopics. And this process goes on in a cyclic manner, and we will continue to do so till 31st May. So why the date chosen has been 31st May? Because on 2nd June is your prelims of UPSC CSE 2019, and we will end this series only one day before your prelims exam. So let's start our discussion. The first question is, so today is the lecture of current affairs, that is lecture number 3. So first question is, consider the following statements. First, Inspire 2018 held in New Delhi. Second, it is an event that focuses on youth of India. Which of the above statements is correct? So we have to choose the correct statement. Let me tell you, friends, that yes, first is correct. Inspire 2018 held in New Delhi, but it is not an event that focuses on youth of India. It is basically it was an event that focused on the bringing energy efficiency in usage of energy. So the only one statement is correct. So first statement is correct. So the answer is A. So solution is A. So here is the full form of this INSPIRE, that is innovation research and research in energy efficiency, and it is an international symposium to promote innovation and research in energy efficiency. It held in New Delhi. And it focuses on grid management, e-mobility, financial instruments and technologies for energy efficiency in India. So it was jointly organized by Bureau of Energy Efficiency, the Energy and Resources Institute, and the Asian Development Bank, and the United Nations Environmental Program, and the Administrative Staff College of India. So this is about your first question. So let's move on to the second question. Second question is, consider the following statements about Energy Efficiency Revolving Fund. First, it is a fund proposed to be created by Energy Efficiency Services Limited with grant from Green Energy Facility. Second is that this Energy Efficiency Services Limited is a government body under the Ministry of Power, Government of India. So we have to choose the correct statement. Let me tell you, friends, that both of these statements are correct. Yes, this is a fund basically which is to be created with a grant from Green Energy Facility, and it will be created by Energy Efficiency Services Limited. 2-3 months back, this Energy Efficiency Services Limited signed an agreement with the Asian Development Bank to develop this fund with a grant from Green Environment Facility, and this Energy Efficiency Services Limited is a government body under the Ministry of Power. So both 1 and 2 are correct. So the solution is C. So here is the explanation. So it is a fund that is proposed to be created by an agreement for a global environment facility grant of US $13 million to establish an energy efficiency revolving fund. So aim is to expand investments in energy efficiency market in India, build market diversification and scale up existing technologies. So here is explanation about this Energy Efficiency Services Limited. So it is a body under the Ministry of Power, Government of India, working towards mainstreaming energy efficiency and is implementing world's largest energy efficiency portfolio in country. So this is about your second question. Let's move on to the third question. Third question is, consider the following about the Swadesh Darshan scheme. First, it is a scheme under the Ministry of Culture. Second, the share of central and state governments is 80:20 respectively. So we have to choose the correct statement. So friends, let me tell you that it is not a scheme under the Ministry of Culture. It is in fact a scheme under the Ministry of Tourism. So first statement is wrong, and the second statement is also wrong, because it is fully central funded scheme. So 100% funding is available from central government, and also funds are so to be mobilized by corporate social responsibility by harnessing the CSR part of public corporations as well as other corporates. So both these statements are incorrect. So the correct statement is both of these statements are wrong. So the answer is D, that is none of them. So solution is, it is by mistake here mentioned C. Sorry friends, it is D, not C, it is D. None of these is correct. So the answer features of this, it is a 100 it is 100% centrally funded for the project components undertaken for public funding. So it leverages corporate social responsibility, and it has a national steering committee under the Ministry of Tourism as chairman. And also this funding of individual project vary from state to state, and this funding is dependent upon the detailed reports that are prepared by program management consultant, which is appointed by the member secretary of the national steering committee, who is the nodal officer for this whole scheme. So mission directorate headed by a member secretary in NSE is a nodal officer, and he appoints this program management consultant, which prepares a detailed project report and the funding aspect, and then depending upon that report the funding is decided. So this is the structure. So basically there is a national steering committee which is chaired by your Ministry of Tourism, Minister of Tourism, and then in national steering committee a member secretary is there who will be the nodal officer of the this whole scheme, and he will be called mission directorate, and he will appoint program management consultant. So this is about your third question. Let's move on to the fourth question. Fourth question is, consider the following statements about LEAP program. First, it is a program for leadership development in second tier academicians of higher public educational institutions. Second, the program would be implemented by Ministry of Human Resource Development. So we have to choose the correct statement. Let me tell you friends that yes, it is a program basically to develop the leadership qualities in the second tier academicians of higher public education institutions, with keeping in mind that these second tier academicians will take in future the leading positions in their respective institutions. And let me tell you friends that second statement is not correct. It is not implemented by Ministry of Human Resource and Development. So the answer is only one statement is correct. So the answer is A. So about this program, basically this is a program in which 3 months, 3 weeks of training, flagship leadership development training is given, and 2 weeks in which there is a 2 week domestic training and 1 week foreign training for second level academic functionaries in public funded higher education institutions. The main objective is to prepare second year academic heads who are potentially likely to assume leadership roles in the future. So the implementation of LEAP program is through this the 15 national institution ranking framework, top ranked Indian institutions namely, and the foreign universities identified for the training are also within this top 100 in the world global rankings. So this is about your fourth question. Let's move on to the fifth question. Fifth question is, consider the following statements about World Food Program. First, it is the Food Assistance Branch of the United Nations. Second, it is world's largest humanitarian organization addressing hunger and promoting food security. Third, it is part of United Nations Development Program. So we have to choose the correct statement. Let me tell you friends that all of these are correct, and there is one important point also. It is the largest humanitarian organization, and it provides food assistance. It is a Food Assistance Branch of United Nations, and it's it is the largest humanitarian organization addressing hunger and promoting food security, and it is part of United Nations Development Group, and also of its it is part of its executive committee. So all of these statements are correct. So answer is D. So recently the Chinese e-commerce giant Alibaba Group has signed a strategic partnership to support its effort to eliminate hunger globally by 2030. So it is planning, this Alibaba Cloud is planning to prepare world hunger map, which will help in streamlining operations relating to ending hunger. So the main purpose of this World Food Program is to kind of not just provide food assistance, but in fact to eliminate the need for food aid itself. So the main purpose is to make the individuals, or for that matter nations self-dependent on for producing enough food, and that is accessible to every section of society and every strata of society. So it was born in 1961, and it is governed by an executive board which consists of representatives from member states, and it is a member of United Nations Development Group, and it's a part of its executive committee. And these operations are funded voluntarily by the world governments, corporations and private donors. So it has other goals also that are in consonance with reducing the hunger problem. So this is all about, friends, today's lecture. If you like the questions, if you like the video, then please do hit a like, do ensure that you subscribe to our channel, and do not forget to press the bell icon, because then only you will get all the important notifications relating to UPSC CSE 2019 that we update on our channel. So thank you, friends, have a very nice day. Thank you very much.